Let's pretend Farmer Girl, and this is my son Ryan, and he's going to show us how to make some hard cider.
Hello. Today, like my mom said, we're going to make some hard apple cider. It's actually pretty simple. All you need is some apple cider, which you can either do with cider or juice. The only difference is that cider is unfiltered, juice is filtered, so cider will be cloudy like this, have a little bit different flavor. So basically all you need is some juice or cider, and you need some yeast. You can use baking yeast if you want, but might not give the best flavor. Today we're using some Red Star champagne yeast. And if you decide to do this, you can pretty much choose whatever juice you want. You just want to make sure it doesn't have any preservatives in it. The ideal is pasteurized, but unfiltered if you're going to make cider. Let's see. So what we're going to do first is an optional step. And so we're going to take the hydrometer reading just to see how much sugar is in the cider to kind of give us an idea of how much alcohol I end up making. But it's not necessary at all, so I'm just going to pour it in real quick. And one thing that, if you do make a hydrometer reading, you just want to make sure that you don't pour it back in unless you make sure it's sanitized, because the nice thing about doing it straight in the jar is that everything in here is sanitized, and that's what you want when you make the cider, because if some bacteria or anything gets in there, it could add off flavors. So just leave it out. So here's the reading. Let's see. Potential alcohol says looks like about 6. Right. Where is that? Okay. Looks like it says about 7%. Which is perfectly fine, because it should go down to 7 to 0, which will give us 7%, but we're actually going to boil up some brown sugar, just bump it up a little bit, give it a little bit different flavor. So, okay, now what we're going to do is we got the brown sugar ready. We put together 2 cups, about a pound worth. We're going to add this to some of the cider that we heated up, just to help it dissolve. And you can experiment with kind of whatever amount that you want. 1 pound for 1 gallon might be a bit much, but just thought we'd give it a try. Okay, we boiled some of the cider and brown sugar, so made sure it's all dissolved. I'm just going to add this back in there. I just washed this to make sure it's all sanitized. Hopefully this will all fit. Okay, so we just poured in what we had boiled with the brown sugar, and I gave it a good shake, and now we're going to measure the yeast. I did another hydrometer reading, and it shows that it'll, with added sugar, it'll be about 10%, so pretty good. So I'm just going to put the yeast in now. We don't need to use a whole packet of this because it's made from 5 gallons. So we'll just sprinkle some in there. That's probably about right. Looks the same as the baking yeast, but has different characteristics. So it's good for champagne. Because it's champagne yeast, it'll ferment it out pretty dry. So if you want to have a sweet cider, what you can do is you can stabilize it using, I think, bentonite tablets or Campton tablets, which will basically kill all the yeast. then you could add more sugar, so you have a kind of sweet cider. So I'm just going to give this a quick shake, get the yeast all in there. And typically you'd use an airlock used for brewing or winemaking, but it's not really necessary. You can just put some foil on top. Just like this. What it is, I loosened the cap some because fermentation is going to produce a CO2, and you don't want the CO2 to get trapped in there because it'll break your glass. So you want to be able to get out, but you don't want any oxygen to get in. That's probably a bit small. You don't want any oxygen in, so that's the main purpose of this. So that is... Now you can just sit it in the closet, give it probably a couple weeks or a month.